Number 6, Mateo Turner. Number 13, George Dublin. Number 5, Zion Smith. Number 10, Devin Dill. Number 9, Aaron Burgess. Number 11, Jaquari Thomas. Number 4, Jacob Green. Number 12, Brandon Phillips. Number 7, Nathan Trott. Number 14, Keaton Pewter. Number 3, Darius Tucker. And of course, the coaches for the under 12 All-Star team is Sergio Goda and Jawan Thomas. Let's give a round of applause to all of our under 12 All-Star teams. A round of applause for all of our under 12 teams. Don't start dying out on me, oh Lord, no.
Moments away from the kickoff of the fourth and final Kappa All-Star match featuring the under-12s. And the East have already claimed bragging rights. They've won all three of the previous matches, albeit one goal.
It's been a really close day. I mean, each game has been decided by one goal. So far, to the advantage of the East.
We'll see what the West can do with the under-12s right now. Once again, the West in all red, white, the East with the white tops. Well, this one, you can tell the tempo is definitely a little quicker in this one.
Yeah.
So we see number 6 there, Jomé Bean Lindo. You're going to have to watch him.
East able to clear, taking no chances. Jomé Bean Lindo, one of the top players for the West squad.
Taking the throw. Now with the... Azende Ferbit. Ferbit again. To Bean Lindo. Cleared there by George Dublin.
Oh,
pressure.
The battle, Aaron Burgess going at it with the keeper. Solomon Burrows. Throwing now for the West.
Here's Devin Dill, cleared by the West. Backpedaling over there is Zaya Wolf Simpson. Dean Lindo into touch. Throw in by George Dublin down the line. Looking for big number 11, Ja'Cory Thomas. Corner kick. Thomas chipping. Another corner.
Good ball here.
Oh, the crossbar.
That was a great corner that time.
Number four going across field.
Sende Ferbert there. Too far. Goal kick for the West side.
Goal kick for the East.
I'm sorry, the East.
Dean Lindo in the mix. He's one of the bigger players out there, headed forward that time.
Throwing this time for the West.
Oh, this is interesting. Thomas.
Ja'Cory Thomas again, another corner. Thomas was the one that crossed that beautiful ball the last time that got rung off the crossbar. Nice move by Zion Smith, blocked away by the West, and now a chance, but a bit too far.
Yeah, they're looking for Wolf Simpson up there. Zaya Wolf Simpson, speedy number 7. Aaron Burgess with his hands full over there on the left side for the East. Well, you know we're getting close to the big action when you see Wendell Shine Hayward come in. He normally blows the saxophone, gets you all ready for the big action. He's just been escorted in. We're not that far away from the big ISL, MISL matchup. Somebody has to go to Johnny Barnes tomorrow morning. And I spoke to, I don't see my friend Alan Stetzer or Basin, but he said he knows that he doesn't have to get up that early.
Oh, he's already talking trash.
Oh, yeah. It has started. Back to our under 12, Kappa under 12 final here.
Oh, great tackle over there by the West. Sending Ferbert that time.
Oh, this is interesting. Yep.
Goal.
Yep, they finally found Wolf Simpson. Look, they all lay down. You see that? That's new. They all lay down.
That's awesome.
So... Zaya Wolf Simpson And that came in the fifth minute? What did you put it down? Is it fifth or sixth?
Fifth minute. Fifth minute. It all started in the defensive end. The great tackle by Ferber. Great pass up ahead and then the finish.
Well, the writing was on the wall. They have been attempting to feed Simpson for quite a while, and he's a fleet of foot. He's rather quick, even though a bit stocky. But they have been trying to find him. Ferbert now with a free kick. Low, hard. Oh, yes.
Nika Lowe that time on the rebound. Those free kicks are so dangerous. Not just the initial opportunity, but then the rebound comes out, and all of a sudden, the West, just like that in the span of 2 minutes, has a 2-0 lead. It's great awareness by Lowe to be on the doorstep there waiting for the rebound. And let's see, goal. They call
free
it again?
No, he's saying,
he's say handball.
He's saying it's a free kick.
Call it a handball.
Well, I guess the West is trying to make a statement here, Paul.
Well, they need to put one in the win column here today.
Yeah, or you're going to have what we call clean sweep.
There's going to be a lot of talking going on from the east side.
You couldn't even win one match. Oh, there you go, Simpson again. Simpson and Ferbert, a lot of the play falls to them. Oh, well done there. Oh, look at that.
West now dominating play.
Vance Brown.
There's Lowe again lurking around the keeper. Made it a much tougher save there with him right there standing on the doorstep. Oh, great ball.
Looking for Simpson again. Oh, he couldn't cut back. He couldn't cut back.
Good defensive play that time by the East All-Stars, Theo Turner. And really, though, give Simpson credit. He couldn't cut back, but he was able to control his body and still get a pretty good look at the goal.
Well, the West have just put on a very tall striker. Number 14. Casey Butterfield must be all of 5'8", 5'10". Reminding you, this is under 12.
Under 12, right.
Oh, there's Butterfield getting a first touch. He's going to fire.
Ball that was well meant.
Here's the West once again. Haley Eve laying it off for Sean Stevens. Also over there, Omari Tucker. Zande Ferbert is having a great first half here. Ferbert loses possession there, though. Vance Brown going long, looking for Keaton Pewter.
Nice defensive play by the West. DeAndre Dowling down there.
Yeah, who's the guy in the blue shirt down
there? It's Mr. Super Friends himself.
Yeah. Earl Basden. Hello. I just mentioned your name, Super Shine Hayward. This is my good friend, Paul Mittermeier. I said we must be getting close to the main event. They just escorted in Mr. Music himself, Wendell Super Shine Hayward. Okay, you're there. Believe me when I tell you.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh yeah. You're on. Okay. You're gonna be playing just before the main match, is it?
Yeah, that's what I understand.
Yeah. Yeah. And nice to see you out.
Hey man, it's a pleasure. You know, we were doing this together at one time, man. I was observing, or even kicking the ball around.
Yeah.
Is that better?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Yeah, we were in the orange and white.
That's right. You're going way back. Yeah, we played football with Devonshire Colts many moons ago.
Many moons ago.
Gosh, man, I even forgot. You had me wondering what exactly.
What was I talking about?
Yeah, flashback. I had a flashback there.
How about that?
But we've got so much talent here, Shine. We've seen under 8s, under 10s, under 12s, and then coming up the big MISL match. And every time I go somewhere, like over there at the tennis court or whatever, and I see you come in, I say, oh, it's getting close.
Something's about to happen.
Yeah, yeah. What exactly are you going to play?
I'm actually going to do our national anthem.
National anthem? Okay.
And I must say, I do take great pride in playing our national anthem.
Sure.
Because it is our national anthem.
Of course.
You know, be it what it may, you know, some folks, you know, have a problem with the lyrics.
Right.
Start on God save our gracious queen. But nonetheless, you know, it is our national anthem.
Right.
And from a musician standpoint, it's a very beautiful melody, man. I love the melody.
Yes.
And I'm going to try to make good of it today and hopefully encourage some of the listeners to gain a better appreciation for their national anthem.
All right. Well, Wendell Shine Hayward, thank you for taking out a moment.
No problems. My pleasure.
Coming by.
Hey, always a pleasure,
you
man.
You know that. You
for
know
sure.
that.
Thanks much.
All right. There we go. Back to Paul Mittermeier now, as we're just over 2 minutes remaining in the first half of this under 12 Kappa All-Star Final. Good to talk to my good friend Wendell Shine Hayward as usual. It's strange, I saw him, Paul, come in, but I didn't know he
stuck in behind you.
He did. I didn't know he had come up the steps. All right, we're under 2 minutes now. Ferbert with the throw off the head of, just skims off the head of Butterfield. Goes all the way out to number 11 down to Sean Stevens, who fires one from over there, but it's wide of goal. Gosh, that was a real flashback, Paul.
Yeah?
Reminding me of football there. I was really lost for a second as to what he was referring to. But yeah, I did play the game a little, way back when. 1 minute and 15 seconds. It's still the West leading 2-0. Strikes from Wolf Simpson and Lowe. And you're watching all of the action on Bermuda Sports Network. Oh, it's a chance for one, yes!
Yes, goal!
Yes, it's 2-1. On Bermuda Sports Network. Oh, it's a chance for one. Yes.
Yes, goal.
Yes, it's 2-1. And we're under 1 minute. And it's number 7 down there. It's going to be Nathan Trott.
It was a big goal for the East as the West had controlled play for most of the half. And in the 14th minute, the East come back and pull one back. And David Dill, a great feed off the throw-in from the wing. And finds cutting Trott for the goal. We're still not done yet. We still have a little bit of time here.
Yep. Still got about 15 seconds or so. Here's the goal scorer, Trott, trying to switch it inside. He's no doubt looking for Jacob Green, but was cut out.
East with one more chance, but I don't think I have enough time here as clock will expire. Got ourselves another great game here.
Yep. Very close indeed. So after the first half of play in the under 12 Kappa All-Star Final, it's the West leading 2-1 with still the second half to go.